Well, welcome back to Steve Rob Reviews. Today, we're going to revisit the last video I did about the 300 amp breaker up at my camp that was just out of the box, wouldn't work. I believe it was, I dropped 11 volts on that breaker. Should have been 13.1, and it was just like 2 volts. So I got this thing all tore apart now, and I'm going to show you what's going on with it. And I'd like you guys who are really sharp on DC designs with DC voltage to let me know if you can figure out something here that I'm going to show you from the manufacturer. I saved the little card there that shows what brand this is. And I have bought this brand for the last 10 years, never had a problem. So I ordered some more, but I didn't pick this brand. I picked another generic brand, and we're going to see how that one works as well. So let's go over to the bench here. I'm going to show you how this thing is. I've already taken it apart once, just so I could, instead of spending like 20 minutes getting this thing taken apart. It was painful taking it apart. Okay, so let's get to it, and I'll show you what we've got going on here. Well, here we go right here. I'd like you to take a look at, you could see there's a post here. And there's always, of course, there's a post on the other side. But take a look at this right here. Now this here is saying LED light indicator. Now it's either a positive and a positive or a negative and a negative. So how do you get this LED light to actually go on? I don't understand it at all, but I've got lots of Swift people on my channel that can maybe give me some insight to that. And now we'll move on to the breaker. Okay, so here is the breaker here. There it is right there. And let me just see if I could show you here. Yeah, you can see right here is where that LED light is supposed to come on. And of course, I've got it going across my two negative conductors. And this is a 300 amp. You can see the 300 there. So let's just take it apart. Now what I did is I had all these little pins here I had to take out. I had to drill them out. And so let's just take a look here and I'll show you how this actually works. Now on the bottom here, all this is just a push button here. And this knob just goes over top of here. So the whole idea of this is when you press this button, it just presses on, let me see, this little tab here. And this tab, when you press on it, it moves a little fiber disc in between the two conductors with this spring. So I'll take this off for you. There's just one nut, so you can take this piece out here, which is easy to take out. So we'll just take this off here. And I was amazed how this is constructed. Okay, let me just take this out here. I'll just take it all out. Okay, so first off, this pin here is attached to here, and this here is attached to here. Now this here is some kind of a, I don't know. I think the whole idea behind this is if this goes beyond a certain amount of amperage, it will just lift up. And what it does is here's the little fiber disc here, and it goes in between like this, and that breaks the circuit off, on. So when this is on like this, you have no conductivity from here to here to here. And when it's open, this pad here will connect with this pad. Now, if you take a good look there, I don't know if this is going to focus. You can see how much that is pitted. And I'll show you this one here too. You can see that. See how pitted that is in there? Now, that came right out of the box like that. So, of course, you are not getting the full contact of all this hunk of brass or copper, whatever that is. So, these little pit marks here. So that must have happened when they were doing their testing to bring it up to 300 amps. and this is what happened. So this may have just been a bad piece of metal that's contaminated. Like I say, I've never had this happen to me before. And this is just that little fiber piece. And look at that for one time use. You could see how it's burnt there. So I really don't know what happened in this situation, but this is the idea behind it. And I think it's a fairly decent design. I only pay $10 for these. So the whole idea is this just separates, you know, goes back and forth underneath and just covers up the conductors and it breaks the circuit. So yeah, that's how that one works and that's why it failed. Well, what do you think? Guys, these guys have been following the channel a long time, know that there's no way I was going to let them get away with that without me actually tearing it apart and find out what was the problem. And leave me a comment down below if you can figure out how they could possibly get that LED light to go on. Am I missing something here or what? Because I can't figure out how. And, you know, so I'm thinking, okay, the side that's got the LED light on, guys, I'm just thinking like there's no way I'm going to take a positive and touch that negative side because it's just going to go boom, right? So how do they do it? I have no idea. Is this just marketing or am I missing something? And for you that have never seen this channel before, if you want, I'll put a link down below for the last video about when I was up at my cabin up in Northern Ontario. And you could see exactly what I was talking about. And, you know, it's kind of funny when I'm thinking about how this actually works. So I'll be looking forward to read the comments below. Thanks for joining me here today. And if you haven't seen this channel before, you're welcome to subscribe. Come back again now, eh? Cheers.